What's up, everybody? I'm going to be doing a water relay. I've got a fire at the school right now. Figured I would do this in a fire academy video, but this was the very first fire that I had when testing. So I figured I'd do it in a live action situation. So we got fire in the cafeteria of the school. As you can see, we got heavy smoke and fire blown out the window over there. It's a hard, difficult area to access. So I'm going to show you guys how this whole system works. So I'm going to start by going to the back of the engine, pulling off the relay by pressing R. I'm just going to stretch it all the way to my engine. If I run out, I still got my second engine, which will give me enough to reach. Still pulling. Alright, so what we're going to do is keep dragging it all the way over here. And we're going to connect it to the inlet right here. As you can see, hoses, physics, and stuff still need a little bit of work, but it's a process. Alright, so our hose kind of went through the ground there, but it's okay. We're going to grab this, and we're going to connect it to the discharge right here. That is the one connection you use for water relay right there. So it's always going to be that one. The second one is for water supply, so you connect that to a hydrant. So from there, if we got the discharge and the inlet, that means our other engine, if I pump here, charges the line. And if I go to my engine 78 driver, I've got water. So what I'll do now is go ahead and start stretching the line from this switch. Fire alarm is annoying as hell, but it's doing its job. Alright, so I'm gonna do this a little differently. Drop this over here. Pull it off of the line. There's our fire in the kitchen. Looks like it's blown out a window. Now I'll do this. This is like the best way to connect the hoses, honestly. If you do it a different way, you're gonna have issues with the physics. I mean, it's not gonna cause any game-breaking issues, it shouldn't, but it'll look retarded when you have hoses and stuff going through the walls. So this is like a fire academy lesson, but not really. More of like a training situation. Alright, so what I'm gonna do now, start pumping. Oh, we don't have we haven't hooked up the line yet. So what I'm gonna do here, back here, go, start the line. By a nozzle. Line of charge, as you can see. Let's get to work on this fire. I'm gonna bring an extra lens actually, because we're gonna hit it. Otherwise, I'm gonna be hitting this from pretty far away. I'll just do this. Here comes the water. And that, guys, is how you do water relay. So you can connect a 2.5 to a tower ladder, or you can connect the 3.5, which is the relay line down there. So the relay is what we use, which is a 3.5 to get water from engine 30 on the hydrant out there. And then the 2.5 is what we stretch inside, which was our attack line. So those are the same sizes they use in the FDNY. Yeah, you can see the setup here. It's a good thing to know, especially, I think right now the only situation you really need it would be at the school. But I did actually include a hydrant right there just in case you didn't want to do a water relay. It's not too common in the FDNY, but unless there's like a frozen hydrant or a 1070 or something. But it's good to have, good to know. A lot of people requested it, so I added that in. But that's the basics how to do it. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned from it. The hoses have gotten a lot more stable, and we're still working on them, obviously. You can see they could do some more work, but it's progress. And there's still some more things we want to do and fix. As you can see, we are like constantly fixing and progressing. It's not like we just release this update and let it sit there bugged out forever. So guys, go download 0.6.7. Go report some bugs and some feedback, and I look forward to making the game better every day.